Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Dear students, welcome to another lecture of Electromagnetic Field Theory. In this lecture, we will cover topics from chapter number 2. The title name of the chapter is Vector Analysis. Our main topics are scalar and vectors. We will define them and I'll present some example of scalar and vectors. Addition of vectors, we can add vectors by two rules, by parallelogram rule and by head to tail rule. Product of vector, when vectors are multiplied, the resultant may be a scalar quantity or may be a vector quantity, and these products are called scalar product and vector product. Knowing the knowledge of addition of vectors and product of vectors, we will be able to derive the parallelogram law, which is also known as law of cosine. And our final topic of the lecture will be the triple product. Physical quantities. In previous lecture, we divided physical quantity into base and derived physical quantities. In this lecture, we will divide the physical quantities into scalar quantities and vector quantities. But first, let's study what are scalar quantities. Scalar quantities are those physical quantities which need only magnitude for its complete specification. A magnitude contains a number and a proper unit. Following are the example of scalar physical quantities: electric charge, current, energy, mass, density, volume, etc. are representing the scalar physical quantities. For example, if we talk about a single electron, then the magnitude of electric charge on single electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Scalar can be a function of space and time. It means that scalar may be vary with the time and position. Like temperature is a scalar quantity. And near a heating source, the temperature is greater than the temperature at far away from the source. So in this case, the temperature depends upon the position. Vector quantities. The specification of a vector at a given location and time requires both a magnitude and a direction. Which means that those physical quantities which are completely described by magnitude as well as by a direction known as vector physical quantities. Example of vector physical quantities are displacement, velocity, acceleration, force, electric and magnetic field intensity, and many more, because these vectors need magnitude part and the directional part as well. Vector may and may not be a space and time dependent. We have certain vector fields which depend upon space and time. In this slide, we will represent two representation of a vector: mathematical representation and a graphical representation. For mathematical representation, we first describe the symbolic representation of a vector. A vector can be symbolically represented by a letter with an arrow ahead, or a bold-faced letter will represent a vector. And it is defined as a vector is equal to a magnitude, and this small a is for the direction part. Or this bold face letter represent vector, which is equal to a modulus, and small a which represent the direction. So if a letter without arrow or a letter in two parallel lines will represent the magnitude part of the vector, and the small a represent a unit vector which is a dimensionless quantity, and the magnitude of a unit vector will be always equal to 1. And the formula for unit vector AA, which represent the direction of vector A, is equal to A vector divided by A magnitude. The graphical representation of vector, a straight line segment which represent the magnitude part of the vector with an arrow head at one side of the length. So this is the graphical representation of a vector. If the length of a vector is larger, so its magnitude will be larger, and if the length of the vector is shorter, then the magnitude of the vector will be smaller. Now we can add vectors by two rules. First, a parallelogram rule, in which the given vector must be in different direction, so they must not lie on the same line. So these vector construct a plane, and we will coincide the tail of these vector to a single point. Like this, we coincide the tail of vector A with the tail of vector B, and we'll draw their parallel vectors. So we will draw the parallel vector of vector A, which is on the opposite side. This is the parallel vector of vector A, and similarly we will draw the parallel vector of vector B, which is the opposite side of vector B. So these dotted line represent the parallel vector of vector B, and so it will form a parallelogram, and the diagonal is the resultant of these two vectors. The statement is, two vector A and B, and they construct a plane, their sum is another vector C, is the diagonal vector of the parallelogram formed by A and B from the same point. So remember, we do not change the direction of the given vector. Another rule of vector addition is head to tail rule. Again, we have two vectors, and we are going to add them according to head to tail rules. We will follow this rule, and according to this rule we will coincide the head of one vector with the tail of other vector. If we are doing A plus B, then we will add A and B in such a way that head of vector A is coincide with the tail of vector B, and this rule is only will apply on the given vector. So the given vector are A and B. We follow the rule, and the resultant will be drawn in such a way that the tail of the resultant coincide with the tail of the first vector, and head of the resultant vector coincide with the head of the last vector. So the statement is here. And there are few laws which are hold in vector addition, commutative law. If we add A vector with a B vector, or if we add B vector with A vector, the resultant must be the same, and this is known as the commutative law. Associative law, in which three vector are adding in different order. First we add B plus C, and then the resultant is added with the vector A, and we will obtain resultant vector, and the same resultant vector will be obtained if we add A vector with B vector, and their resultant is added with the C vector. So both the results will be the same, and this is called the associative law. Negative of a vector, when two vectors are added and the resultant is a null vector, then these vector must be a negative of one another. For example, if we add minus b vector with the plus b vector, So these two vector will add up to zero, and we can say that these two vector have same magnitude but opposite in direction. So they will give us a null vector. Sometime we multiply a scalar number with a vector. So when a vector A is multiplied by a scalar number k, then the resultant vector has magnitude like this. If k is multiplied with a vector A and we will get a new vector, the magnitude of the resultant vector may and may not be greater than magnitude of a vector A. If k is less than 1, then the magnitude of the resultant will be smaller than A. If k is greater than 1, then the magnitude of the resultant will be greater than A. And remember that the direction of the given vector and the new resultant vector will be the same. Product of vectors. As we add vector with another vector, the resultant is a vector quantity, but when we multiply vector with another vector, there are possible results. Vector product may be scalar, product may give us a vector quantity as well. So in physics we have many physical quantity which are self-scalar, but they are the resultant of the product of two vector. Like the power is a scalar quantity which comes from the product of velocity and force, and we have many other examples of such a quantity which are self-scalar, but they are the resultant of the product of two vectors. Such a product will call scalar product or dot product, and we can define the dot product as the product of vector A and B. The dot product or the scalar product of vector A and B is denoted by A dot B and is equal to the product of three things: the magnitude of A, magnitude of B, and the cosine of the angle between these vector. So it is mathematically written as A dot B, which represent the dot product or scalar product, is equal to A B cos of theta between them. And here from the figure it is clear that when two vector A and B are apart theta AB from one another, there is another angle which is the larger angle than theta AB, but in definition we put a smaller angle which is theta AB. And the condition on theta AB is this theta AB will be smaller than 180 degree or pi radian. The dot product of two vector will simply give the product of magnitudes of the given vector when these vector lie in the same direction, or when these vector are parallel, then the angle between them is zero and cos zero will give us one. So we will simply left with the product of their magnitude. And the dot product can either be positive or negative, which again depends upon the theta. If theta is less than 90, then the dot product will be positive, and if the theta is greater than 90, then the dot product will be negative. And the dot product will be zero if theta is equal to 90 degree or pi by 2 radian. In this case the vector will call perpendicular vectors or orthogonal vectors. Laws hold in dot product or in scalar product. If we perform A dot B or B dot A, the resultant will be the same. So the dot product or the scalar product is commutative. The distributive law also hold in dot product, and it say that A dot B plus C is equal to A dot B plus A dot C. So A is distributed among B and C. So if we perform this operation or the right hand side operation, the resultant will be the same. We multiply A dot A, the resultant will be A square. As told earlier, the examples of scalar physical quantities are Verdon, kinetic energy, power, and electric and magnetic flux. Parallelogram law, which is also known as law of cosine. And in the given figure, two vectors A and B, which are added by parallelogram rule, and we will obtain the resultant, which is the diagonal of the parallelogram made by A vector and B vector. So remember that there are two angles, alpha and theta AB. Both are angles between A and B, but alpha is the inner angle of the parallelogram and theta AB is the outer angle of the parallelogram. And in figure it is clearly mentioned that theta AB is smaller than alpha, and we have to derive the parallelogram law. So do not misunderstand the parallelogram law with the parallelogram rule. So according to parallelogram law, the magnitude of the resultant of two vectors C is equal to under the root A square plus B square minus 2 times AB cos of alpha. So from parallelogram rule, C can be written as A plus B. C is the diagonal vector of the parallelogram, which is made by A vector and B vector. So if we take the dot product of C with the C, so we can write A plus B dot A plus B, as the value of C is A vector plus B vector. Now we are going to multiply the each term of this bracket with each term of this bracket. So we will get four terms like this. C dot C is equal to A dot A plus A dot B plus B dot A plus B dot B. Now we will applying the dot product on these vector, but remember that the dot product is commutative, so we can change the order of B dot A to A dot B, and we will simply get C dot C. A dot A will give us A square, B dot B will give us B square plus 2 times A dot B. And if we remove the square or C, so we must put a square root on the right hand side. So our next line will be A square plus B square plus 2 A dot B is equal to AB cos theta AB and square root. Remember that in dot product, the angle between two vector is the smaller angle. So from figure, the theta AB is smaller than the alpha angle. These two angle lies on the same line, so their sum must be equal to pi or 180. So alpha when added with theta AB, this will give us pi or 180 degree. Or if you want to find the value of theta AB, so theta AB must be equal to pi minus alpha. So cos theta AB, for theta AB we put pi minus alpha. And if we open this trigonometric function, the resultant is simply minus cos alpha. So for cos theta AB, we can write minus cos alpha. So in this expression, if we put the value of cos theta AB, which is minus cos alpha, we will get our result. So C is equal to under the root A square plus B square minus 2AB cos alpha, which is law of cosine. vector product or cross product. There are many physical quantities which are vector, but they are the resultant of the multiplication of two vector quantities. So we will define a product for such a physical quantities. The vector product of two vector A and B, we consider two vector A and B. Their cross product or vector product is denoted by A cross B, which is a vector. So A cross B is a vector which will be perpendicular to the plane containing A and B. If we look at the figure, A and B are the two given vectors which constructing a plane if you draw their parallel sides. So this side is parallel to vector B and this is parallel side of to vector A and constructing a plane. So the resultant of A and B will be perpendicular to this plane. So this green vector representing the resultant, which is A cross B. In vector we have two parts, the magnitude part. So the magnitude of the resultant vector will be AB sine theta AB, and theta is the smaller angle between A vector and B vector. And the direction of the resultant can be found with the help of a right hand rule, and the thumb direction will be the direction of the resultant. If we stretch our finger of the right hand and rotate it toward B, so the thumb will up, and this is represented by the yellow vector, which is AN, the normal unit vector of a plane A and B. So our formula for the cross product for any two vectors will be like A cross B is equal to AB sine theta AB into AN. This modulus part represent the magnitude of the resultant, and the small AN represent the direction of the resultant vector. And the cross product of two vector will be zero when the angle between them is zero. And the magnitude of the cross product is maximum when the angle between the given vector is 90. And in this case, the vector are perpendicular. The laws hold in cross product. The cross product is anti-commutative, and this tells us that A cross B not equal to B cross A, and A cross B equal to minus B cross A. So this property is known as anti-commutative. And then if we multiply A with a B plus C, so if we perform the left hand side, the resultant will be the same. If we perform A cross B and A cross C and then add them, we will get the same result. So distributive property also holds in cross product. And A cross B cross C not simply equal to A cross B cross C. So the associative property not hold in the vector multiplication or cross multiplication. Examples of vector product are torque, because torque can be written as cross product of displacement and force. Magnetic force can be written as cross product of velocity and magnetic field. And similarly, angular momentum can also be written as a product of two vectors. Triple product. Sometime we are dealing with the multiplication of three vectors. In this slide we will multiply three vector to get scalar and vector as a result. Scalar triple product, when three vectors are multiplied in such a way that their resultant is a scalar quantity, will call scalar triple product. For example, we multiply A in dot operation with B cross C. So if you look at this expression, this part of the expression will give you a vector, which is again multiply with vector A in dot operation, so the overall result is a scalar quantity. So a volume is a scalar quantity and it can be written as product of three vectors. And if we change the order of these vectors in cyclic manner, so the resultant will be the unchanged. That is, if we perform A dot B cross C, the resultant will be the same if we perform B dot C cross A or C dot A cross B. This is called a cyclic permutation, which is hold in scalar triple product. When three vectors are multiplied and the resultant is a vector quantity, then this product will be called vector triple product. And the resultant of vector triple product can be written as the difference of two vectors, like A cross B cross C is the three vectors which are multiplying in cross operation. So B cross C will give us a vector, and this vector will again multiply with A in cross operation, so the overall result will be a vector. And we can open this expression as A cross B cross C is equal to B vector into A dot C minus C vector into A dot B. It is a useful identity known as Bake minus Cabe rule. Except K, all the letters represent their corresponding vector. That is, B represent B vector, A small a represent A vector, C represent C vector. Let's sum up our lecture. What we have learned today, we have defined scalar and vectors along with examples. Then we add vectors and addition of vector by two rules, by parallelogram rule and by head to tail rule. And then we multiply vectors and study the scalar product and vector product, and then derive the parallelogram law. And this law is also known as law of cosine. In next lecture, we will study the coordinate systems. We have three coordinate system, but first we will learn the generalized coordinate system, and then we'll move to the specific coordinate system. The specific coordinate systems are the rectangular coordinate system, the cylindrical coordinate system, and the spherical coordinate system. I hope you will learn this lecture, and if you have any question or any difficulties, you can contact me at my email. Thanks, and Allah Hafiz.